Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important event of these days. Today's broadcast. Statement by the National Assembly of Western Armenia. Regular sitting of the National Assembly of Western Armenia took place. European Council President calls on Armenia and Azerbaijan to resume negotiations in constructive spirit. 2,000 hectares will be irrigated by the end of the year as a result of the operation of the Artsakh-Kartal road. Iran loses right to vote in UN General Assembly. 1877 to 1878 Russian-Turkish War and Hamidian regiments. 20 million people in Turkey live below the poverty line. Snow in the regions adjacent to the Black Sea of Western Armenia. National Assembly of the Republic of Western Armenia, Decision Number 19, 12 of June 2021. President of the Republic of Western Armenia and President of the National Assembly of the Republic of Western Armenia. We invite you to participate at the 5th meeting of the 2nd session of the National Assembly of the Republic of Western Armenia, Saturday, 12 June 2021, 5 p.m. France, Armenia, 5 p.m., Argentina, 12 p.m. Address, Maison des Associations, 288 Chemin de Saint-Claude, 06600 Antibes, program on Saturday, 12 June 2021 at 5 p.m. To submit and approve the agenda for the meeting, presentation of the new ministerial positions of the Western Armenia government. Present the activities implemented in 2021. Amend the new electoral code in the coming years. Make possible amendment to the new electoral code. On this day in Armenia at the meeting. Present action plans for the second half of 2021 to 2022. Thank you in advance. The Speaker of the National Assembly of the Republic of Western Armenia, Leonardo Basmajian. The regular sitting of the National Assembly of Western Armenia took place yesterday. The sitting was chaired by the Speaker of the National Assembly of Western Armenia, Leonardo Basmajian. The sitting was held remotely. Issues related to the 5th Congress of the 2nd session were discussed during the session, as well as the organizational issues of the conference entitled What is Western Armenia for the Zoom application in Latin American countries. It should be reminded that the regular sitting of the government of Western Armenia will take place today. The details will be presented in our tomorrow's programs. In his June 2nd meeting with caretaker Prime Minister of Armenia Nikol Pashinyan and phone call with President Ilham Aliyev of Azerbaijan, President of the European Council Charles Michel stressed the importance for the EU of stability and prosperity of the South Caucasus and of deepening relations with the two partner countries, the European Council said in a news release. He recalled that the full implementation of the 9th November 2020 ceasefire declaration by Azerbaijan and Armenia is essential for regional security and stability. The EU is ready to provide expertise on border delimitation and demarcation and to support confidence building. The European Union also encourages both parties to cooperate, as a matter of urgency, on the return of detainees and full transparency with regard to minefields and other important humanitarian issues. The EU is providing almost 20 million euros in humanitarian assistance and will continue to be engaged. Addressing these immediate challenges is, however, only a first step towards a sustainable, peaceful settlement. The PSC called on both sides to engage in renewed negotiations in a constructive spirit. The European Union has a profound interest in the security, stability, and prosperity of the South Caucasus region as an integral part of the EU's Eastern Partnership, the statement says. President of the Republic of Artsakh, Aray Kartunyan, made a working trip to Askeran province. The head of the state got acquainted for the first time with the construction progress of the main junction of Karkar River, which is being constructed on state funds. The president instructed to increase the staff for putting it into full operation before the end of the year. As a result, more than 2,000 hectares of land in the sub-region will become sustainable irrigation systems, which will significantly change the share of agricultural production in the area. As part of his visit, the president met with residents of the Khanapat-Ramort communities. Both security and socio-economic issues were discussed. Praising the resettlement of the dozens of displaced families in the two communities, the president stressed the need to continue the process, pledging that the government would intensify its efforts in this regard. Iran and the Central African Republic were stripped of voting power in the UN General Assembly due to non-payment of regular fees for 2 years. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres said in a letter to the president of the 75th General Assembly, Volkan Bozkir, Terdat AM reported. Currently, there are 5 member states covered by the Article 19 of the UN Charter, the document says. The article in question says that a member of the organization that has a debt being stripped of voting right if the debt reaches or exceeds the amount of fees for 2 full years. Besides Iran and the CAR, there are 3 other states in the list, Comoros, Sao Tome and Principe, and Somalia. However, the Secretary General underscores that these 3 countries will retain their voting right until the 75th Assembly is over. The UN membership fee is defined based on a country's average GDP during a 10-year period, with consideration of income per capita and foreign debt. A country may be allowed to vote if the General Assembly rules that the payment failure took place because of circumstances out of the state's control. According to the Secretary General's letter, Iran has to pay $16,251,298 for restoration of voting power, while the CAR has to pay $29,395. Although the Hamidi regiments were predominantly Kurdish, they included Arab, Turkmen, and Karabakh tribes. The so-called Russian-Turkish War of 1877 to 1878, the outcome of which had marked the policy of Abdulhamid II, who unfortunately ascended the throne, was at once of the brink of war and almost a turning point in the Ottoman Empire. The Russian-Turkish War of April 1877 to 1878 caused the old Ottoman Empire dearly. The treaties of Agia Stefanos, signed on 3 March 1878, and Berlin, signed on 13 of July 1878, contained very strict preconditions. The Ottoman Empire ended its rule in the Balkans, losing about a third of its land or 20% of its population. Under Article 16 of San Stefano and Article 61 of Berlin, the Ottomans were obliged to carry out reforms in the interest of Armenian society, as well as to take measures to protect Armenians from attacks by Kurds and Circassians and suppress the rebellions of the latter. The full article will be available on our website. The Workers' Committee of the People's Democratic Party has issued a written statement on the occasion of Anti-Poverty Week, June 1st to 7th. The statement reads, 60% of Turkey's working population earn the minimum wage or less. Over 20 million people actually live below the poverty line. If the unemployed also count, the figure reaches 30 million. The Justice and Development Party, in power since 2002, has created a fragile consumer-based economy in 10 years, does not produce, does not create jobs, and depends on the latest flows of foreign capital. The AKP government has made flexible, insecure employment, withdrawal from trade unions, voluntary redundancy, impoverishment, job it has failed to create, starving Turkish workers and suicide as its main political objectives. As the air temperature in the eastern part of western Armenia decreased, the high plateaus turned white due to snowfall. Residents of the Kavron Plateau, 2,300 meters above the sea level in Chamli Hamshen district of Rais, were greeted by a snow surprise in the morning. It should be noted that only a few days ago, plus 30 degrees of heat was registered here. Now I present you Kırbetek Dağerk. The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.